Hello everyone, and welcome to another review. Today, I have a review for you of a fragrance that is quite hyped. It is very popular in the community. It is none other than Creed's Aventus. Here is the bottle and presentation. It looks just like the other Creeds. The only difference is it has kind of a unique feel or a unique design to it. I personally think that this is the best looking of all the Creed fragrances. It's combining black with silver, with the natural, you know, the glass, white glass bottle that comes along with it. The top has that. It says Aventus in the middle. And the box kind of follows the same feature. Now, the front of the bottle has kind of like this. It's almost like ribbed, almost. But either way, it's a very classy design. I find it the best out of all the other Creed fragrances. Now, this fragrance was released in 2010. It is created by Olivier Creed. As well as with the rest of the Creed fragrances, and it can be purchased pretty much for the standard Creed prices. So for 120 milliliters, you're going to pay about $315, not including tax. For 75 milliliters, you're going to pay about, it was $260. Generally, with the Creed fragrances, the more you purchase of the fragrance, volume-wise, the less you're going to pay per volume, or per milliliter for that volume. So the higher you go up, the cheaper it gets overall, but obviously you're spending a little bit more money for it. Now, on to the actual notes for this fragrance. The notes of this fragrance consist of, for the top, we have blackcurrant, Italian bergamot, apple, and pineapple. For our mid, we have roses, dry birch, Moroccan jasmine, and patchouli. And for our base, we have musk, oak moss, ambergris, and vanilla. Now, what do you get from this fragrance? This fragrance is, it's very unique. What you get when you spray it immediately off is citrus. It's a very powerful, pungent citrus. This fragrance is a modern man that basically I envision, ultimately. It's a very nice, modern type of a scent. You're gonna get Creed's signature freshness that comes right off the bat, that comes right off at you. Even with the citrus that's kind of in there, Creed always has that unique take for it. And maybe the ambergris that they put in their fragrance, whether it's the natural ingredients that they use in their fragrance, Creed's freshness has kind of, the freshness itself almost seems to be a bit of a signature to the entire house of Creed. And this fragrance is no exception to this. The difference with this fragrance is it packs a punch. It packs a very strong punch at that. So while it may be your typical citrus starting off, it is one that is packing a heavy punch. Now, the apple, the pineapple, and the bergamot. The apple and the pineapple and the bergamot are really what are making up the citrus. And as you start to kind of go into the heart phase of the fragrance, you get a little bit of the rose and a little bit of the jasmine. So you can get a little bit of florals. It adds a little bit of a feminine touch to it. Overall, though, they are not prominent at all. And if you miss those notes, it would not surprise me at all. But once you get to the base, you start to get a little bit of a muskiness that is actually present throughout the entire fragrance. As the one prominent thing about this fragrance is that even though it has no pine, it has a piney feel to it. And that's because of the combination of notes, whether it be the pineapple, whether it be the apple in it, combined with the rest of the notes, it kind of has this pine-ish feel to it. It's very hard to describe other than that. It can come off a little bit as smoky as well. I'm not sure, to be perfectly honest, I don't know what note is actually giving it that smoky note. It could be the blackcurrant mixed in with the, the ambergris and the vanilla, as well as the musk, to kind of give it that smoky type of a feel. But either way, the musk is going to be, you know, prevalent throughout most of the fragrance, especially once you start to get to the heart of it. And essentially what you're going to get from this fragrance is a citrus that has a very sharp citrus, not really sharp, just strong citrus that has very strong wooden undertones throughout the fragrance that is smoothened out by vanilla. Now, outside of that, the birch is pretty prominent as well in this fragrance. The birch and the rest of the woods is, again, mixes extremely well with the musk. Overall, this is actually kind of a weird blend. I mean, at the very top, you can't really say that it's nothing out of the ordinary. I mean, you know, citrus combined with a woody base is, you know, nothing really to sneeze at. But it's the way that Creed has actually done it in this fragrance that makes it really special. The ambergris also gives it kind of like this this animalistic feel, this animalistic note to the actual fragrance that gives it a little bit of edginess as well. So it keeps in line with the whole modern type of appearance. In fact, whenever I casually go out wearing a suit, this is definitely the fragrance that I choose. Sometimes I choose to wear this to work, other places like that. So how many sprays are you going to go ahead and give this one? Anywhere between 2 and 3 sprays. I think 3 sprays even can be a little much. This fragrance is that powerful and it is pretty strong. Yes, definitely 2 or 3 sprays for this fragrance and you're actually fine. I usually go 1 to the chest area and 1 to the head, and usually I'm good for it. There have been a couple times where I've sprayed 1 here, 1 here, and then 1 to the head, and then been good with it. But other than that, you may be able to get away with a little bit more. You may be able to get away with a little bit less. But just be warned that this isn't your typical Creed that's lacking in punch or lacking in power. For occasion, you can wear this on any occasion. I haven't really found an occasion that you really can't wear this to, whether it be school, whether it be work, whether it be date, whether it be going out casually, whether it be going to the club, you name it, you can wear it. This fragrance has that enough of a serious undertone to be used well for serious occasions, and it's enough of a playful undertone to be used for playful occasions. So you can use it for any of those scenarios. For season-wise, again, any season, you can wear this one in. It's not cloying enough, or should I say powerful enough that it will choke you out during the summer, unless you over-apply, obviously. But it's also got the strength to persist in the winter. It can really be used for year-round, and this is a classic case that I can think of a signature scent. So, yes, definitely any season. For age group, any age group, I think, can pull this one off. Even the high schoolers, I think they can actually pull this one off as well. But I think it actually works best on, should I say, 25 to 50-ish range, basically. I think pretty much can pull it off really well. But any age group can really wear this one. Projection and Sillage, both are absolutely fantastic. Now, this fragrance has generated actually a lot of hype, and a lot of people love this fragrance, and I personally agree with a lot that has been said, but there is a little bit of tempering down that actually needs to be done with this fragrance per se. But when I spoke with people, I kind of got a more clear impression of how Aventus went across with the general public. Here's what a couple people thought.
I don't smell anything else besides citrus in here. I'm gonna have to go. It has another familiar smell to another cologne. I'm trying to think of, I think it's Cerruti Image that this reminds me of a little bit because of the citrus smell. I'm going to go with C rating, because I don't like the full citrusy. I don't smell anything else besides citrus on here.
My original reaction was Lysol, and it's strong, it's piney, not liking this one at all, and yeah, it would be a good freshener in like in a cabin in the woods, so you get rid of that dusky smell. You could probably use it instead of a Renews It. So I would definitely give this a D, not an F, because I'm sure somebody would really like this, but that person is not me.
I'm totally in for the pine is a little much. It is kind of making me think bug spray at first, but then once the alcohol off, it was better. It kind of reminds me of, and I can't remember what it was called, but there was a fragrance that all the high school boys wore in the 90s that I personally thought was a little much for 15-year-old boys, and it reminds me a little bit of that, because that was also a very pine-forward fragrance. I'm going to give it a C. It's not bad. I mean, it's not bad. It's a little, I think maybe it's just the personal association with the past. that's well left in the past. But I mean, but it is not unpleasant, and certainly pine is a good fragrance for men, I think, generally. I'm not sure that this is the right one.
So this one kind of smells, I hate to use an overused word, woodsy. But that's how it smells to me, and it's kind of subtle. It's not bad, though. However, I don't think it's necessarily excellent. I'll give it like a B-.
So as you can see, there were some interesting reactions right off the bat for the grades. One gave it a C, another a D, another a C, and another a B-. So not exactly things that absolutely jump out and say, this is an absolutely fantastic fragrance. Personally, I love the fragrance, but what the people said was quite opposite from it. Now, after they actually gave their opinion, I went and asked some more people, got more opinions, and they were generally a little bit more positive for it, but they weren't off the wall crazy for the fragrance as some other fragrances or anything like that. But the tone, basically citrus, strong, piney, pine, woods. For negative, they would say that it actually smells like Lysol or house cleaner, basically something. And that got me curious for a second, and I wondered if anyone else picked up on it. So I went to look over a couple reviews and saw that some people who didn't like it, that's exactly what they said that it smelled and reminded them of: Pine Sol or Lysol or stuff or household cleaners like that with that pine smell. So if you are not a fan of those smells or anything like that, then you may definitely want to try out this one before you actually give it a whirl or anything like that. Now, you can see one interesting thing was, as Heather mentioned, the reason that she thought that she might not like this as much was because of a past association, which is also very important when smelling fragrances and smelling certain cells or certain smells. So yes, definitely keep that in mind going forward with it. So let's just get on to the actual ratings for this. Now for ratings, for scent, I'm going to give this one an A- for scent. It's an absolutely fantastic scent. I love the modern interpretation. I believe that this is the modern man type of a fragrance. And the most important thing that I think with this scent is the confidence that it especially gives people. Guys love this scent more. This is like catnip for men. Men absolutely love this scent. Women, a good amount of women love this scent, but there are some who also don't like this scent as well. So, you know, temper enthusiasms. As for me, I love the scent. I give it an A-. For projection, I'm going to go ahead and give this one an A- as well. Projection is absolutely fantastic, outstanding. It's not the absolute best, but one thing to keep in mind is for projection, this is a fragrance that plays tricks on your nose. So just because you think it's subtle, it's not exactly subtle and will go across. For sillage, I'm going to give this one an A- for sillage. It definitely leaves scent trail. People will know that you were there. They will definitely know, if they know the scent, they'll definitely know it was you that was around there. So sillage is definite, solid A-. For uniqueness, a B-. The reason I'm giving it a B- for uniqueness is that even though, yes, it is, I would consider a pretty unique fragrance, the reason why it gets minus points on it and only gets a B- for uniqueness is because at its core, it still is, your typical citrus woods. It's just done in such a fantastic way. So that's why it still gets good ratings for what I would consider its uniqueness, but it does lose points because it still is, at its very base, the citrus woods. All right. For longevity, I'm going to go ahead and give this one an A-. Longevity is absolutely fantastic on this. Expect anywhere between 12 and 15 hours. That's personally what I got for it. And it'll linger much longer than that. You won't be able to, it won't project after that words, but it will still linger. A case in point was I had applied this fragrance, I think, at around 6:30 in the morning before I left to work and went off to work. And right after work, I had a yoga class. And I remember walking into the room with my mat, laid it down, and a girl across the room was like, "Who smells that?" Sorry, I have a cold. But she's like, who smells like that? And I thought for a second, is that talking about me? And then she walked up, smelled me, and she was like, "Yep, that's you. Smells good." So 12 hours later, or 12 plus hours later, She could still definitely smell it, even though that it didn't really project to me, but she could definitely smell it across the room, and it was still going strong at that point. So I have a feeling that my nose got used to it. So projection, definitely solid. Longevity. Now, versatility. I'm going to give this one an A+. You cannot beat it with versatility. You can wear this for any occasion, at any time, any place. There is nothing that I can see that you can't possibly wear it for. Versatility is an A+. For compliments, I'm going to give this one a B for compliments. The reason it gets a B is simply because it is a complimented fragrance. However, the main reason it's not getting the best remarks is because I haven't found it to be absolutely drop dead, you know, guaranteed to get you the compliment six, etc., blah, 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 stuff like that. You know, there were some people who thought it was just okay. There were some people who didn't like it at all. But there were a good amount of people who actually absolutely loved it. And kind of like in that longevity explanation that I just gave you, there were people who could smell you literally right after the fact and would tell you that you smell good. So I have gotten a good amount of compliments with this fragrance, but at the same time, it's still tempered. So I'm giving it a solid B. And for overall, I'm going to give this one fragrance an A. If you are looking for a Creed fragrance that lasts long, I would definitely say look in this area. For a $315 price tag, there was never any time that I would ever recommend anyone blind buy any fragrance for that matter. It may be considered a safe-ish type fragrance, and I could kind of see that because there are not many people who don't like that pine sol smell or that Lysol type of a smell at its worst, quote unquote, because I don't necessarily think it's truly a bad smell, but the overall scent for it, you know, the apple, the pineapple, the smokiness, it oozes with the ambergris, oozes a sort of masculinity that you can really grab out of this fragrance. So a fantastic scent. I absolutely love it. I give it a solid, man, just a solid A, and I don't really have any qualms with it at all, to be honest. So if you have any questions whatsoever, please feel free. Leave me a comment, send me a message, do whatever you have to do. Thank you. Take care of yourselves and have a great day. Oh, just one more thing I actually forgot to touch on. This thing also kind of gets a mention because the one thing that people love to jump out about are the batch variations. Now, as well as with some other, I've spoken with some Creed representatives, and I actually have the exact same impression or opinion that they do on it. I really don't give a crap about the batch variations. And I'll say it right now, right here. You know, I realize there are people who got all over the batch variations saying, I have A01, N01, and blah, blah, blah. I'm not sure. I don't care, to be perfectly honest. I have smelled differences, quote unquote, in them, but they're not big enough differences for me to go crazy over. So that pretty much ends it for there. For those of you who want to know what batch variation mine is, it is slot A42. Yeah, A42 or some crap like that. A42 10. That's it. Have a great day, guys.